Hello everybody and welcome to Mustang Connection's first YouTube channel roll call. This is kind of like a mail call, but it's a roll call. I'm going to share some great cars from Auctions America and also show you some other great YouTube channels. I'm going to list their channel name at the bottom. So check it out and enjoy and hope you like it. It's a long one.
Yeah, I'm going to do like a multiple shout out here for the Mustang guys. I'm going to do one for all the guys, Billy, Adam, Joe, Mitchell. So let's just do it this way. I'm going to put all the Mustang guys in with these three cool cars right here. We've got a 68 GT500 convertible, the 428 Lease Interceptor motor in it. And they're all kind of parked close together. And there's a 70, a little 70 Grande right here. And then a 1965 GT Coupe. So, Prometheus, Super Kroner, Rudderfly, Cobra Fanatic, MD Kingsley, Mustang Medic. Who else am I forgetting? This goes out to all the guys that have Mustang videos up. It's three nice ones together. A couple little coupes, and obviously in the Shelby is the coup d'etat, but this one's going at no reserve. I'm curious to see if I'm around to see this go. Darren, this one's for you, buddy. It's a 1962 camper. VW microbus. Very nicely restored. It's got the luggage rack on top. They put the curtains in it. It's fully restored. It's going Saturday. It's going to bring a premium. Can't really look inside. I'll just kind of give you a look at the bodywork, which is pretty straight. It's hard to get a slab side that straight. Lot of material there to get straight. So, quick peek inside. So set up like a little camper, little closet back there. Just nicely restored. It smells like fresh paint on it. That one's for you, bud. All right, Rare Rat, this one's for you. It's a 1969 Z28. Flippin' awesome car. Looks great in this color. Unusual, you don't see them like this too often. Beautifully restored. 69 Z28, the classic Camaro. Stick shift car. Let's say it's 302. Let's see what it is. What's going on? It is a DZ302 car. 410 rear end, too. Wow. Rally green, black stripes. Very nice. Ubin, here's a nice Nova for you, man. I know you're doing your, just painted yours in white. Look at that, it says 382. So this is a stroked small block. There was no such animal back then, so. It's probably started life as a 350 or a 327. It's a four speed. Wow, this is really nicely restored. Resto-modded, if you will. Got Magnum 500s on it. A little Hurst badge in the back. I know Darren's also working on a Nova too, so. Another one for you, buddy. But you behave and check it out. All right, David, Loki Doki, this one's for you, man. It's a Laguna Seca Boss 302. I really like these. I'm pretty sure you do too. There aren't a lot of late model Mustangs here. I just thought you would enjoy this one. Very nice condition, actually. This one's going on Friday. Of course, these have the rear seat delete. Just a beautiful car. In red and black. Boss 302 Laguna Seca. David, Loki Doki, buddy. Hope you enjoy the video. Thanks for watching all my stuff all the time. And shout outs for you, man.
I just go look at the car.
All right, Ken, this one's for you, buddy. Street Rodder. It's the only Corvair I could find. It's a ramp side. It's not an actual little Corvair, but it's a Corvair pickup. So these are still powered by the air-cooled engines. This one's a four-speed. Look at how much room there is back here. And I take it the motor's under here. So Kenny, Street Rodder, this Corvair is dedicated to you, my friend. In honor of your former ownership and love of Corvairs, I'm still sure, still loving them, but this one's for you, dude. All right, this one's for John Carey. We don't do a lot of, we don't interact a lot on back and forth, but I know he's a big member of the garage gang. He's restoring his Jag, and it's great to watch all of his craftsmanship he puts into it. So let's take a look at this one right here. This one's for you, buddy. It's a 1963 Jaguar E-Type Series 1. It's got a 3.8 in it. Beautifully restored.
Wow. Yeah.
Lot number 3095 Saturn. This would be a high dollar car. Just outstanding. Huh? Bumper's been a little bumperette. Let's get these all to work. Very nice. All right, Dean, this one's for you, buddy. Full throttle. It's a 69 GMC Sierra Grande. Top of the line for 69. Beautifully restored, wow. Digging a houndstooth interior in it. Very fresh restoration. The black on here is gorgeous. What a unique car. Don't see a lot of these restored to this level. I don't think I've ever seen the Sierra Grande. I guess this was the luxury trucks before they were luxury trucks. Okay, Daniel O'Grady. Wasabi Cars, this is for you, buddy. 1972 Honda 2600. This is right up your alley. It's not in wasabi condition, though. This one's been restored. This would have been one of the first Hondas sold here. Not the first, but certainly this is when they were starting to become mass produced and shipped and imported. Right before the gas crunch. The ultimate in simplicity. This is definitely a micro car. This is so early. This preceded the Civic even. The little Civic CVCCs weren't much bigger than these. Little antenna on top. This is in nice shape.
3250, ladies and gentlemen. 3250.
First model of the West Coast imported to the United States beginning in 69, yeah. 600 two-cylinder air-cooled engine.
3250.
And ladies and gentlemen, the 1961
there it is.
Ford
Daniel O'Grady, Wasabi Cars. This is a miniature vignette of Wasabi Car video for you, buddy. All right, this is a 1919 Matt truck, and I'm giving this shout out to none other than the Shade Tree Fix-It Man. Why? I don't know. There's no trains out here, bud. But no, this just is really cool. Look at the chain drive on this thing. I'll probably do a separate video just on this truck. It's a flatbed, but look at the chain drive on this thing. How cool is that? So this one's for you, George. This shout out goes to you. Hey, look, it does have, it looks like. This lamp almost looks like a railroad style lamp, so. 1919 Mac industrial stake or flatbed truck. Never seen anything like it. Mac International Motor. All right, Greg's Garage, this one's for you, Greg. I know you did that Ghia restoration a little while back. This is a really nice, it's a 57. Greg shows a little bit of everything in his channel, including his guitars. He's got a Garisarama coming up. A little bit out of my area, but I know they're going to be doing some work on some different stuff. So check out Greg's channel. He's a big time YouTube Garage Gang guy. So I thought I would just shoot this for you. And of course, VW Darren too, even though I've already got his a bus on there. All right, Steve, Mr. Will, assistance for you, buddy. It's a Plymouth Ferry. There's not a lot of Mopar stuff here. This one's just really cool, so I thought I'd film this for you. There's a couple of later model, big-bodied Dodges over there, but this Fury is just really cool. Thought you'd enjoy it.
Attention, ladies and gentlemen, if you've seen a bag and a blue cooler, please return that to one of the auctions. American representative, blue shirt. Gentleman has some valuable device.
Look at the size of these fins back here. Look at this.
Inside that bag and that cooler.
Spare tire with the trunk. Pretty cool.
Please return the bag and the cooler. If you've seen that out in the parking lot, you may have picked it up by accident. It's out in the parking lot. Please return it back to the
look at that steering wheel. Look at the horn buttons. Look at the rear view mirrors. It's so cool. Look at that speed up. It's so different.
If you've seen that, please return it. Thank you.
1960 Plymouth Fury convertible. There you go, Mr. Wells. This one's for you, buddy. All right, this one goes out to all the guys working on their 65-6 coupes. This one is in a restoration project waiting to happen. What makes this unique is it is a K-Cut. It's a 289 Hypo car.
I'm taking it off the grill.
And it's going at no reserve, but this car needs everything.
Let me run down and get some Toyota green.
65 K-Code coupe. It's being sold with no reserve. Let's see how this does. Stick shift car. Check out this little car. They have a lot of cool micro cars. This thing is pretty sweet. It's a 1976 Soito Brake Camping. No idea. This thing is nuts. I'll tell you what, Ron, I haven't put one out for you. This one's for you, buddy. You love to engineer and change and fix things. How would you like to work on this car? This is awesome. Look at the seats.
This would be great for like cross-country trip, wouldn't it?
Yeah. This is crazy. It's a three-wheeler, too. It's funny. God. This thing can't weigh more than, 800 pounds. It's probably like a heavy motorcycle, I guess. There's nothing to it. It's a little tin can. And it's a convertible. This little part right here comes back. And what kind of camping are you doing there? All right, Michael Wright. I was kind of racking my brain, and I thought, you know what? Let's show Michael some vintage German iron. I know you like the classic Mercedes, too. And look how nice this is. It's a 67 Mercedes SL 250.
Ladies and gentlemen, a real tri-power GTO.
And a 69 280 SL.
Body style change from 64 to 65.
Side by side. Both nicely restored.
GTOs have been upfitted with it. This is a real one, and it's all documented.
These both have mechanical fuel injection.
36, 37. I got 36, maybe about 37. 36, maybe about 37. Anybody doing it? $37,000. I got 36, maybe about 37. I got 36, maybe about 37.
Time about 37. Not sure last year's body style. 71, mate? No. 72?
Who got 36.5 on the GTO?
I'm sure when the 450 SL came out, I think it's 73. So maybe 71, 72 would have been the last year of this body style.
$36,000.
It's got a Pioneer radio. It doesn't have the original Becker in it. Let's see if this one does.
2091 is a 1994 Ferrari.
It still has its original Becker. Look at that.
This example is finishing Corsa Rosa. Over beige interior with a top speed of 175
right
miles per hour. Fun sporty automobile, sure not to disappoint. There's been a complete belt service done within the last 6,000 miles. Car has a clean history report, including the sale are the owner's and service manuals, tools, original window sticker, service records, and the tonneau cover.
Hi, how much? How much here? How much on the spider? Right, I'm gonna get 47. How many dollars on it? Red color, is it any better? Right, I'm gonna get 22,000. 21 bid, 22. 21 maybe number 22. I get 21 maybe number 22, but number 2. I get 21 bid number 2. I get 21 maybe number 22, but number 22. I get 21 maybe number 22. 23. I get 22 maybe number 23. I get 22 maybe number 3. I get 22 maybe number 23.
Matt, calling you out. Bucks Wood Shop.
I get 22 maybe number 23.
Look at this work. This is all fresh on this Chrysler Town and Country. I cannot even imagine what it takes to do this kind of joint work and then get everything like this to bow and fit. Look at the work on this. And then it's got veneers on the side. What do you think, Matt? I picked this Chrysler Town and Country for you, buddy. 1947. Look at this thing. It's sold. I'm curious to see what it sold for. I wasn't here when it sold. Chrysler Town and Country Woody convertible. Okay, Trevor Mud Maniac. This one's for you, buddy. It's a little 74 Ford Bronco, fully lifted. I know this is earlier than yours. You've got the larger body, but this thing's really clean. Got some custom touches in there. Obviously that tilt wheel. It's red black flares, white top, has Corvo style, Cobra racing seats in it. Nice lift, nice little Bronco. Okay, Trevor. What maniac for you, dude.
When it comes to bringing complaints, as we do anytime before the auction, then when the sale begins, our live